Boy, you cannot believe how long I've been waiting to have the time to just play this bum-ass game, man. And I guess it's good timing because the weekend I come back is the weekend we get Pink Diamond. Not Pink Diamond. They're not going to do that early. Diamond Michael Jordan packs, all right? And they actually have a Ruby Taco Fall as the reward just so that we don't have to, like, endure collecting. I'm not going to collect all them shits anyway, but I was notable. It made everybody attainable without having to collect the whole thing for the best card. And this Lamar Odom right here is fucking
on crack!
Insane. This guy should be on your team immediately if you have the MT to do it, because he is a buy now player. And I cannot think of a more all-around small forward, power forward in the game right now. Immediately when it was his badges that really did it for me, because if you've been paying attention so far, he has every single possible notable badge, as well as the fact that he is a 6'10 small forward power forward with 86 ball control. And I'm actually going to show you the improved stats that you get depending on your coach boost. I personally use Terry Stotts, but he has quick draw, dead eye, flexible release, green machine, clamps, intimidator, off-ball pest, all of the good defensive badges to be able to play either inside or outside, and he can speed boost. This card is insane. And he has, as you're about to see right now, which is the thing I was curious of the most, they actually fucked around and gave him the goddamn Mopeat. This card is fucking cracked. This card is, I don't know what he would look like in the hands of somebody against one of those niggas that, those combo cheesers. I refer to combo cheesers as the ones that, they know how to cheese with Giannis and do hop steps and all that bullshit, but they also play the park, so they know how to be just, wannabe dribble gods. So they can cook you up both ways. Those are the niggas I don't want to play. Those are the niggas I hate playing, and if I see one of them with this guy, it's a GG, because I can't. But with Coach Boost, I definitely think this is one of the better cards, better versatile cards in the game. His three-pointer is in the 90s, mid-range is in the 90s, his ball control at 6'10 goes up to a 90, and he has a 94 driving dunk with all the high dunk tendencies, which I guess really does count nowadays. One thing I did notice, though, is that his durability does go down in a game. I don't know what that's about. I don't know. Maybe he just like goes to the locker room real quick before the game to powder his nose or something like that. But his durability goes down. That's noticeable. And this card, honestly, I don't like to use him the way you'd imagine the people that are going to use him. I like my small forwards to be versatile because I just want them to be able to do a little bit of everything. Because I personally play through my point guard and my shooting guard. That's why you see Steph Curry and Kobe Bryant taking all the goddamn shots. But Lamar Odom is just the facilitator to all of that now, because Curry, if you see me bring the ball up with Curry, just expect me to pull up from the logo. That's just how I play with Curry. And if you see Kobe have the ball, nobody else is getting the ball for that whole possession. He is going to handle the ball and take the shot even if it's two people on him. So Lamar Odom, the way I use him is I like to give him the ball in transition to make the decision of what to do. Because even though he has all of the badges that I had pointed out, the one key badge that he does not have that I wish he had is Dimer. But he does, however, have gold flashy passer, so I do get a good decent boost at least from just using flashies instead of regular Dimers. And that just makes the game a bit more fun, but that's why he's my playmaker in transition. So, like I said, he can do a little bit of everything. Off the dribble, he has a good form too, and he's just fast as shit. Yo, when you use him and see how long this motherfucker is.
What?
That's 6'10", and he's still just quick as shit. I would suggest putting a speed shoe on him, but it's actually not that noticeable that his speed is only at 81. And it sucks because this was a play with friends, right? I at this point in the year when I finally get Christmas break, I try to play as many people as I can that have been asking to play me. I'm on Xbox, by the way, so if you want to play over Christmas break, hit me on Twitter, add me, say that you're from YouTube, and I'll add you back, and I'll try. Because I just run through games instead of forcing myself to go through the aids of my team Unlimited. And this is my first time playing in a good minute. My whole team is different. I pulled this Diamond Mellow, actually, but I didn't even have the time because it was finals week, so I couldn't even really play. And this Melo actually comes off of my bench, and he just acts as the Kobe role. He only takes the shots off the bench along with Jameer Nelson, and the Lamar Odom for that reason ends up never even, I think naturally, he's not going to score more than 10 points in most of my games. Most of the shots he's going to take are like corner, because he has Hall of Fame corner specialist and gold catch and shoot, but a lot of his shots are going to be standstills. and just on the break finishes. So most of his stat lines, especially like the one towards the end of this game, he didn't score all that much. He just had a lot of, he had rebounds, assists, and played D and made plays happen. And it also is quite annoying that the person, because this is what I was guessing, the person that I was playing, fuck you, Twan, he made it his actual mission to shut down Lamar Odom every time he got the ball. If he saw him in transition, he would purposely foul him just to stop the transition, because he's like, you're not getting highlights on me. That's not how the fuck it's going down. So fuck you, Twan. I barely could get any good plays out of this until like the fourth, where it's just like he didn't care
anymore. And boom,
so
goes
I just started giving him the ball and going crazy. So throughout the game, I couldn't get really good highlights. Towards the end, I show you what a couple of the things he can do. But I definitely think you should go out and try this card, because this is a hell of a card, honestly. And if you are going to take those kinds of shots, take those step back threes in the corner, because that Hall of Fame corner specialist actually goes fucking, it's insane. And with his Mo Pete form left-handed, it's just too easy. His dunk tendencies, like I said, are up in the hundreds, so you will take off on people. But I did catch myself getting blocked a bit when I was going to the rim. This fucking Joakim Noah was just, he was so annoying. But definitely, if you just pick up this card, it's not a card that you're going to drop, you know, 40, 50 with. He's just a card that's going to make your team work and that much better, because he can do everything, literally everything. If you pick him up, you will find this out just the same. And my team already has scoring, that's why I'm not really using him for that. I have Kobe and Melo and Steph to take all of my shots. And that's why it raises the question to me, if you get this Odom, or if you already have him, what are you using him for? Are you using him as a scorer because just he's cheese, he's big, he's quick, he's fast, and has a handle? Or are you using him more of a utility player like I am? Also, what position are you using him? Because in these two games, I was using him at small forward, so that might actually have played a role into how he ended up playing in the positions on the court he might have been in. Because I imagine if he was at power forward, I could have gotten more rebounds to him, like caught the board and then push it on the break, rather than getting the board and then passing it to him. But if he's at small forward, then I just have a way bigger lineup, and you know, it's just everybody is fucking 6'9", 6'10". So I guess there's each way that you use him has its own trade-offs. But let me know how you're using him and how efficient or how good he is at the way that you're using him at which position. Because I'm curious. I'm going to switch him around. I might drop Pascal and try him at power forward instead, and then maybe start Melo. But I like the defensive instinct or a defensive presence that Pascal has, and then just using Odom as a playmaker, and then my 1 and 2 are the scorers. That's the chemistry I have going on right now. But if you are using him, let me know how you like him. And if you do have the actual Michael Jordan, not actually, fuck that, that card is kind of underwhelming, to be honest. If you do have the Pink Diamond Chris Bosh, that is the key player of this set, hit me up, because I want to play you. I want to see if I can stop that card. I want to see how good that card is, because I definitely can't fucking afford him. So yeah, bro, I can finally play some 2K. It feels good to be able to just do absolutely nothing and not give a fuck. Like, I don't have to feel bad about just eating shit. So
first move as the executive of the New York Knicks was to sign Lamar Odom, who was on crack.